Dear GATE aspirants, welcome to Veda GATE Academy. In this session, let us see the beautiful discussion happened between student and the interviewer. Commodious, what is the statement of maximum power transfer theorem? Maximum power transfers from source to load or load to source? Commodious, maximum power transfers from source to load when source resistance equal to load resistance, or when load resistance equal to source resistance, or option C, both A and B, which one is correct? Many will say, sir, as per mathematics, if A equals to B, B equals to A, many want to mark option C as correct, which is wrong. Some will say, sir, source resistance should be equals to load resistance. They want to mark option A as correct, again, which is wrong. Come on, yes, which one is correct? Option B is correct. Why option B is correct? Here, who is variable, sir? RTH is variable or RL is variable? Here, RL is variable. We always replace variable with a constant or constant with variable. We always replace variable with constant. We always replace this RL with RTH. Then maximum power is transferred from source to load. Fine, sir. Next, what is the question asked by the interviewer? What is the efficiency of maximum power transfer theorem? What is efficiency formula, DS? Output power by, come on, input power into 100%. Is it not? Efficiency, output power by input power into 100%. Say in this circuit, some load current IL is flowing, say. Now you tell me, what is power absorbed by this load? IL square, RTH. Next, how to get input power? Power delivered by the source is nothing but power absorbed by this resistor plus power absorbed by this resistor. Now come on, tell me, sir. As per KCL, if here the current is IL, what is the value of current here, sir? IL. Now what is power absorbed by this? IL square RTH. Next, what is power absorbed by this? Again IL square RTH. Please put those values here. Efficiency equals to output power IL square RTH by input power. Input power is nothing but power absorbed by this plus power absorbed by this. IL square RTH plus IL square RTH. I can write as 2 IL square RTH into 100%. Come on, engineers. What is the value of efficiency, sir? Efficiency is 50%. From here, the real discussion starts. Interviewer asks, when RL is RTH, efficiency is 50%. Fine, I agree with this. When RL is dash, efficiency is 100%. When RL is RTH, efficiency is 50%. Yes, agreed. When RL is dash, efficiency is 100%. This is what the question asked by the interviewer. Many will think like this. Let me put this statement here. Right. Let me put this statement. When RL is RTH, efficiency is 50%. What is the question asked, sir? When RL is dash, efficiency is 100%. Student, think like this. Sir, here you have multiplied this 50 with the 2. Therefore, I want to multiply this RTH with the 2 and I want to give the answer as 2 RTH. Which is wrong, DS? Why wrong? A small question to you. Daily read for 1 hour, you get 60% of marks, say. Daily read for 2 hours, will you get 120%? Not possible, right? Here also in similar way, 2 RTH is not possible. Sir, when we can apply linearity principle, when we should not apply linearity principle? Linearity principle you can apply when and only when superposition principle as well as homogeneity principle is satisfied. In a simple language, in a layman language, if input-output characteristics are a straight line passing through origin, then only you can apply linearity principle. So here, you can't apply linearity principle. Finally, the answer 2 RTH is wrong, DS. Then what is the answer, sir? Let us analyze this. Let us take RL value as 0 ohms and find what is the efficiency. Clear, sir? Right. some current IL flows here. Okay. What is efficiency, sir? Output power by input power. What is output power? IL square into 0 by what is input power, sir? Input power. The same IL current flows here. VTH into IL into 100%. Come on, engineers. What is the value of efficiency here? It is 0%. One more important point here. When your load resistance is 0 ohms, efficiency is 0%. I repeat my statement. When load resistance is 0 ohms, efficiency is 0%. If anyone asks you the question, for what value of load resistance efficiency is 0%, RL equals to 0 ohms. Fine, sir. Next. Now, our discussion, for what value of RL efficiency would be 100%. Come on, sir. Right. I want to take an example here. Let us take this source value as some 1 volt, source resistance as some 1 ohm, and my load resistance as some 1 mega ohm, say. Fine, sir. You please calculate on your own. Current in this wire would be 9.99 into 10 power minus 7 amperes. And if you calculate the input power, power delivered by the source, efficiency equals to output power by input power. Let me write this input power directly here itself. Output power, if you calculate, you will get as 9.998 into 10 power minus 7 by, this is what the output power. How I calculate this? I square into R. If you do this, you will get output power as this much. Next. Input power, let me write here, yes, 9.99999 into 10 power minus 7 into 100%, this is approximately 99.9%. Come on, engineers, what's the conclusion here? If your load resistance is high, efficiency is approximately equal to 99.9%, or I can say if your load resistance is infinity ohms, your efficiency is 100%. Sir, how it is 100% if load resistance is infinity ohms? See, you can understand like this. Suppose source delivering 100 watts of power, load using 100 watts of power, what is efficiency? 100%. Source delivering 50 watts of power, load using 50 watts of power, what is efficiency? 100%. Source delivering x watts of power, load using x watts of power. Come on, sir. What is efficiency? 100%. Whatever the power that is delivered by the source, if the same amount of power is used by my load, then efficiency is 100%. The conclusion here, for what value of RL, efficiency is 100%. For higher values of load resistance, efficiency is 100%. Clear, sir? Right. Based on this, we can draw one beautiful graph, dears. Beautiful graph. Based on this graph, ISRO exam question I will link. Fine? Right. Let me draw the graph between RL versus power. This is what the axis, sir. X axis is RL. Y axis, power axis. So, as RL varies, the curve varies like this, and slowly the curve falls like this. Fine, sir. Right. And what is this value, dears? What is this value? This is your P max, maximum power. Next, how efficiency curve varies, sir? When RL is RTH, what is efficiency? 50%. And when RL is maximum, efficiency is 100%. Let me mark 50% here. Let me mark 100% here. Yes. Fine, sir. Yes, you tell me, please. When RL is RTH, what is this power, sir? What is power? Maximum power. Fine? Right. These are what two graphs which you can draw, and it's an open challenge. Yes, you can't find these two graphs in a single book. In no book you can find these two graphs, dear. Only with the help of coaching you can get all this. Fine? Only an experienced faculty will give all such information. Fine, dears. Let me link this graph with an ISRO exam question. Shall I slide this? Right. Please see the date of the question that is given here. ISRO exam question. ISRO exam question, 1 volt, 1 ohm, and the load resistance is given as R. Please see the data. For what value of R, 50% of maximum power transfers to R. For what value of R, 50% of maximum power transfers to R. Immediately, student will have an answer. Student gives answer as R equals to 1 ohm. Come on, sir. How many students got R value as 1 ohm? Yes. Many will say R value as 1 ohm. They thought like this. How they thought? They link. Let me explain. Yes. They link this 50%. This 50%. They linked with this 50%. And they have given the answer as RTH, which is 1 ohm. Looking from R, what is RTH, sir? 1 ohm, na? Yes. 1 ohm, they have given the answer like this. But is it correct? It is wrong. Why it is wrong? So, no. Is it 50% of maximum power? Yes, I will show here. 50% of maximum power. But you have linked 50%. Yes, 50% of efficiency. He asked for maximum power. Yes, but you are looking into 50% of efficiency and you are giving RL value as RTH, which is 1 ohm here, which is wrong. Final conclusion here. What axis you have to see? Which y axis you have to see? Efficiency y axis or power y axis you have to see? Examiner asked for 50% of maximum power. Means you have to see power y axis. Come on, sir. What is this power? Maximum power. What is power, sir? Maximum power. Maximum power means 100% of power. Reason, do you have any peaks other than this? We don't have any peaks other than this. Means this is the maximum peak. Maximum peak I can write as 100% of Pmax. Why? Because no other peak is possible here. This is 100% of Pmax. Come on, sir. Now, what is 50%, please? Exactly half of this. I can write this as 50% of Pmax. From here, please draw a line parallel to RL axis. It is touching your curve at how many points? Yes, it is touching my curve at 2 points. From here, please project lines onto your RL axis. Please project lines onto your RL axis. Now tell me, sir, it is touching my RL axis at how many points? At 2 more points. Now you understand the meaning of the question. For what values of R, 50% of maximum power occurs? These two values of R he is asking, sir. But you are giving RL value as RTH, which is 1 ohm here. When RL is RTH, you tell me 50% of maximum power is occurring or 100% of maximum power is occurring? 100% of maximum power is transferred. Clear, DS? Right. Sir, how to get these two values? That is our discussion now. Shall I proceed? Come on, DS. Yes. Fine. Let me slide this. Yes. Hope the board is stable now. Hope it's visible to you, sir. Then, let's proceed further. When R equals to 1 ohm, what you are saying? 100% of maximum power is transferred. Okay, let us find the value of current. 1 volt by the equivalent resistance seen by the source is how much, sir? 2 ohms. How much current flows here? 1 by 2 amperes. What is power absorbed by R? Power absorbed by 1 ohm is half I square into R, half square into 1, which is 1 by 4 watts. Come on, engineers. 1 by 4 watts. It is equated to how much percentage of power? This is equal to 100% of Pmax. This is what the derivation we have done in maximum power transfer theorem, sir. The differentiation we have done. And we have made the value equal to 0. And we got the condition as RL equals to RTH. When RL equal to RTH, maximum power is transferred. That maximum power is nothing but 100% of Pmax here. Fine? Right. Now, exam asking for what value of R? 50% of maximum power will come. Come on, engineers. Tell me, what is the value of current that flows in this circuit? I want this value of RDS. Okay? Right. How much current flows in the circuit? 1 by 1 plus R. Now, tell me, what is power absorbed by R? Power absorbed by R equals to 1 by 1 plus R whole square into R. I want the value of R for what percentage of power? I want the value of R for 50% of Pmax. Come on, sir. 100% of Pmax is 1 by 4 watts. What is 50% of maximum power? It is 1 by 8 watts. If you solve this equation, R value you get as 3 plus R minus 2 root 2 ohms. R value you get as 3 plus R minus 2 root 2 ohms. Let us put these values in the graph which you have drawn earlier and derive beautiful conclusions. Shall we proceed? Yes. This is what the graph we have drawn earlier. And let me put the values here. Come on, sir. When RL is 1 ohm, what is the value of power that is transferred? 100% of Pmax is how much, sir? 1 by 4 watts. 1 by 4 watts. 50% of maximum power. What is the value of power, dears? 1 by 8 watts. Now tell me, for what values of R? One value, 3 minus 2 root 2. What is other value, sir? 3 plus 2 root 2. Means 3 minus 2 root 2. What is the power? 1 by 8 watts. 3 plus 2 root 2. What is the power? 1 by 8 watts. For both the values of resistor, the power absorbed by the load is 1 by 8 watts. Hope you got the point. Next. This is what the question asked in the ISRO exam. ISRO interviewer, in the interview, the question was extended. In what way it is extended, sir? 3 minus 2 root 2, power is 1 by 8 watts. What is the efficiency? Come on, please. It is touching my efficiency curve at what point? This point. Please project a line onto efficiency axis. Come on, engineers, tell me. Efficiency, less than 50% or greater than 50% or equal to 50%. Efficiency is less than 50%. Next. 3 plus 2 root 2, what is the power? 1 by 8 watts. But what is the efficiency, sir? It is greater than 50%. This is what the question asked in the ISRO interview. Extension of the ISRO exam question. Find yes. Right. Finally, what is the conclusion? 3 minus 2 root 2, what is the power? 1 by 8 watts. 3 plus 2 root 2, what is the power? 1 by 8 watts. 3 minus 2 root 2, what is the efficiency? Less than 50%. 3 plus 2 root 2, what is the efficiency, sir? Greater than 50%. Hope you got the point. Still, what extension can be done in this question? Examiner asked for 50% of maximum power. Suppose if examiner gives 25% of maximum power. Come on, sir. What value you have to put there? 25% of maximum power means it is 1 by 16. Suppose if examiner says 75% of maximum power, what do you have to do, sir? 3 by 4 into 1 by 4. 3 by 16. Equate 1 by 1 plus R whole square into R equal to 3 by 16 and get the value of R. Find years. Right. Lastly, the beautiful conclusion. Very, very important conclusion. Suno, please. 100% of Pmax occurs only at one value of R. 100% of Pmax occurs only at one value of R, which is RL equals to RTH. At that value, the efficiency is 50%. I repeat my statement. 100% of maximum power occurs only at one value of R, which is Thevenin's resistance, whereas remaining all the percentage of powers, including 0%, occurs at two different values of R. 100% of Pmax occurs only at one value of R, whereas remaining all the percentage of power, 50%, 25%, 100%, any percentage of powers occurs at two different values of R. One is less than RTH, other one greater than RTH. For all the values less than RTH, efficiency ranges from 0% to 50%. For all the values greater than RTH, efficiency ranges from 50% to 100%. This is what the complete analysis in the maximum power transfer theorem If you are perfect with this crap, open challenge DS. Any test book, any problem, easily you can solve. Find DS? Right. Thank you. All the best.